God is the ultimate source and the ultimate resource. When we function in the world, how we function is determined by many factors. Two primary factors are what brings us to the world and what we bring to the world. What brings us to the world means our antecedents. Now, where did we come from? Now, people often see, okay, which family you belong to, which country you belong to, which race, which religion. So, these are our starting points. That's the source from which we have come to this world. And then, that's our source and we also have our resources, what we bring to the world. Okay, what are the specific talents we have? Now, it doesn't matter which race or something a person is born in, but if somebody has good looks, has good speaking ability, has good managerial skills, good interpersonal skills, these are resources. So basically, our contributions in this world are determined by our sources and our resources. So now, the spiritual wisdom of the Bhagavad Gita helps us to understand that God is the ultimate source and the ultimate resource. The ultimate source means that whatever, wherever we have come from, ultimately that thing has come from Krishna. So, Krishna is the cause of all causes. Aham sarvasya prabhavo mattah sarvam pravartate. Krishna says in 10.8 in the Bhagavad Gita that everything emanates from Him, all material and spiritual worlds are coming from Him. Etad yonini bhutani sarvanityopadharaya aham krishnasya jagata prabhava pralayastatha. In 7.6 in the Bhagavad Gita, Krishna says that everything comes from Him, everything is sustained by Him. So, God is the ultimate source and this has several practical implications. First is, that means we are not limited by the specific source we may belong to. Yes, we may be Indian, we may be African American, we may be British, English, whatever it is. But beyond that, every one of us belongs to the same source. We are all parts of that one family, which is the family of God. This understanding of the common source has the potential for unifying all of us, for integrating us when we live in a divisive and fragmented world today. Along with that, when we understand that God is the ultimate resource, that means that all of us, we have different talents, different abilities, and some of us may have more talents, some of us may have less. And those who have less talents may feel inferior because, oh, I can't do this, I can't do that, I can't speak so fluently, I am a little shy, I can't interrelate so much with people. We all have certain limitations which can bog us down. The limitations don't just limit us practically in our functioning, more damagingly, the limitations limit us mentally. If they make us beat ourselves down, thinking that I can't do that, I can't do that, I can't do that. Now, similarly, along with these limitations, we also have something else that limits us, and that is our own self-sabotaging desires. Now, we succumb to impulsive emotions, we give in to short-sighted desires, short-sighted cravings. Millions upon millions of people today are suffering from addictions which limit and break their capacity for constructive contributions. And yes, our specific resources will remain. Who is tone deaf, can't even understand music, that person may not become the next Mozart. But beyond the specific resources that we have or don't have, there is one resource, which is the ultimate resource that we all can have, and that is God. Of course, God is the supreme being. He is our master. In that sense, He is not our resource. But resource in the sense that we can draw upon Him. We can seek His help. And we can become conscious of Him. If we just learn to focus our consciousness on Him, then that can give us strength to face whatever obstacles or limitations we may face. In the Bhagavad Gita 18th chapter, Krishna says, Mat chittah sarva durgani mat prasadat tarishyasi. that if you become conscious of me, you will cross over all obstacles by my grace. Krishna tells this to Arjuna specifically, tasmat tamuttishya yasho labhasva yutva shatrun bhungshvarajyam samriddham mayaivaite nyatah purvameva nimittamatram bhavasav pisachi. Krishna says, by my arrangement, your enemies have been killed. Just arise and fight. So this understanding that God is there for us, if we just turn to Him, pray to Him, connect with Him through the practice of bhakti, He is there to help us rise, and despite our limitations, when we draw on this ultimate resource, we can bring out our best and make the best contributions. Thank you. Hare Krishna.